Well, Bethlehem's Church of the Nativity is one of the oldest churches in the world. Destroyed and rebuilt numerous times over the centuries, the ancient treasure is now undergoing a major renovation. As CBN's Chris Mitchell shows us, this restoration process is also bringing spiritual renewal to the church's caregivers and to the city of Bethlehem.
Commissioned by the Roman Emperor Constantine at the request of his mother Helena, the Church of the Nativity is built over the place where many believe Jesus was born.
Whenever anybody comes from all over the world, they have to taste and to feel the place where actually Jesus was born here, as to give the people the peace and love.
The Church of the Nativity was built about 1,700 years ago. Since then, it's been destroyed and rebuilt a number of times. The most recent renovation began in 2013.
The 4th century church was built there. It was octagonal in shape, and when it was rebuilt, because it did not have earth-moving equipment, they built on top of it. So you have like a little over 2 feet of change in elevation.
Mazen Karam is CEO of the Bethlehem Development Foundation. Its goal is to raise funds for the renewal of Bethlehem by providing a sustainable life for residents while making the city attractive for visitors. The work started with upgrading Manger Square, then it moved onto the Church of the Nativity. There, the very leaky roof was fixed and the windows.
The original is not here anymore. They replaced them with new windows.
The wall mosaics added to the church more than 850 years ago, as well as the original floor mosaics, desperately needed repair.
11% of the mosaic exists. The rest was lost. So they cleaned up all the mosaic. It was very dirty and, you know, soot and debris, and they cleaned it.
In the process came a surprise.
They discovered the third angel. The third angel was completely covered with plastics.
To help raise money, they also created Adopt a Column to refurbish the church's 50 columns at a cost of about $50,000 each. Others, like art conservator Andreas Miaulis from the Greek company Artis, are working to restore the area by the altar.
We try to bring everything back to the beginning before it damages over the time.
This part of the church is around 250 years old.
This is a very good example because you can see the before and after result. As you can see, all these really dark areas are a result of years and years of residual of soot from candles, as well as human fat, because the majority of the people, they touch everything, so they leave a lot of little oils. We clean it, we restore it, and then where it's missing gold leaves, we try to put it back on again and resurrect it in a way that it once was.
Karam says renovations are conducted project by project based on available funds. The Catholic, Greek Orthodox, and Armenian denominations share guardianship over the church.
Since a long time, we didn't have any restorations, so that's the best thing that is doing now.
They're great because church needs to renovate it, and not only physically. Also, we have to renovate ourselves. We have to be renewed spiritually and be educated about Lord's commandments.
Father Issa Talgiye and Very Reverend Father Azbed Balian say 2 years of COVID keeping away international visitors has been rough, although they have hope for the future.
Even if there are no tourists, no people, still we have prayers, we have services going on. Day by day, the church is open. The local people comes to visit, to pray. Actually, COVID-19 teaches us how to be patient, to have more faith of God, to trust God, that He's standing by us day by day.
I pray that may God really remove all these difficulties. The life will come back normally and regularly, and we'll restart also a communal prayer together, praising the Lord and thanking Him for all the gifts He has given us and sharing His gifts together.
Chris Mitchell, CBN News, the Church of the Nativity, Bethlehem.
Now, once again, a wonderful Christmas message coming from Bethlehem to all the world. May we have a time in the future where we can come together as a community and pray together. That's something to look forward to. So pray for that. Ask God for that. Ask God for relief. And let's bless the people in Bethlehem.